هيا على الفلاح.
Anger is a very big problem, and it is something, it's a condition where we do things faster than we actually think, and we say things quicker than we think about them. So regarding anger, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam has warned us in one narration, and he makes it quite clear to say, لا تغضب. Someone asked him for advice. Please give me advice. You know, a young man met the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and he was so excited, and he says, give me some advice. And I don't know what he was expecting. He must have been expecting some big piece of advice. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam gave him a massive piece of advice. But I think he might have felt that, okay, this is small. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam told him two words, لا تغضب. Don't get angry. So he said, okay, give me some more advice. I heard that. So the Prophet says, لا تغضب. Don't get angry. Control your temper. So he says, okay, fine, give me some more advice. Meaning, you know what, this is easy, man. La taghdab, okay, don't get angry, I heard that. What about anything else? Third time also he said, la taghdab. And he carried on saying the same thing. So maybe that young boy might have had a temper problem. But we learn a lesson up to today from that, that you know when you're angry, you say things and utter things that are so cutting and so harmful. The best thing to do is remain silent. I found something beneficial. The hadith says, first thing you do, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. I ask Allah to protect me from the devil who is accursed. Because anger comes from the devil. Anger, what are you angry about? Temper, you have a temper. You want to scream and shout and swear? No. So, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. And if you are standing, sit down. So say for example, I'm standing. And I'm screaming at you. And I sit down. I can aim, but my screaming is a bit less. And if you're still angry when you sit down, lie down. That's a hadith. Lie down. And you know, you might look silly lying down in the middle of the, what can I say, dining room, for example. You're lying down. And the visitor comes in, what's your husband doing? You know, he's angry. Mashallah, mashallah. But if you lie down, you can't even talk properly. Because you can't say, where am I going to point if I'm lying down? And whom am I going to shout? So it actually works, but we are too shy to implement it. Another thing, drink a bit of water. Have a little bit of, sit down, calm down, drink water. A'udhu billah, may Allah safeguard me. And I found it interesting to hold water in your mouth. Hold water in your mouth. When you calm, let the water go down, swallow it. Why? Because I can't say anything, I'm quiet. I'm not really going to be able to vent. When you calm, you can think again. So many people utter words of divorce in anger, and you know, then they have to go to the scholars, what happened to me, and so on, and there's a huge argument. Some say this, and some say that, and your life is in a mess, and your children are watching, and what have you. No, calm down. Believe me, I don't know, some of you, when I was in London, they asked me a question in one of the programs about my own life. I think it's on the internet, some of you, you might see it there. And I made mention of the fact that when I was much younger, I think between 12 and 14, 12 and maybe 12 and 16, not 16, 12 and 14, 15, I had a temper. And I think it's a temper connected to adolescence. You know, when you're growing, you become 11, you think, you know, you're a big deal, you're powerful, you've got big muscle, and you know, you're a man, and so on, and you can fix up your family members and sort out this person, and you know, that guy is troubling you, you can fix him. Don't worry, everyone thinks they're a big deal. They can fix you also, you know. So, at that age, you need a lot of controlling. So, if you are not going to fight your anger off, it's not just going to disappear. You have to fight your anger. When you're really upset, just calm down, say, Alhamdulillah, Ya Allah, look, I'm angry. And here I am, I've just calmed down, I haven't said anything, I've cooled off. In fact, I've broken into a smile and I've said, I love you. Allahu Akbar. You know what the hadith says? Whoever extinguishes their anger when they knew they could vent it, Allah will grant them the prize they want on the day of judgment. You choose what you want. I'll give it to you. Allahu Akbar. Also, the Quran describes the issue of temper, and it says those who extinguish their anger, they have great opportunity to enter paradise. There we are. Allah speaks of those who enter Jannah, and later on He says, وَالْكَاظِمِينَ الْغَيْظَ وَالْعَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ. The people of paradise will be made up of so many different types of people. Those who control their anger, and those who forgave people. Learn to forgive people. Last night I spoke about forgiveness, and I tell you what helped me. Those who harm you, swear you, talk about you, bad mouth you, spread rumor about you. You know what? Say, Ya Allah, I forgive them. I forgive them. It's totally forgiven. I don't even want to know what they've done. Why? Because when you hold things, it's a burden on you more than them, to be honest with you. Oh, that guy is bad. This guy is bad. This guy, I'm watching out. I can't walk this way. I can't go to that mall. I'm not going to go to this guy's house. That guy, I'm not going to do this. Your life is put so many controls and sanctions on your own life because you don't want to just release. Release it, saying, you know what? Forgive them. It's over. You're a happy man. Your health is okay. You. The only thing that happens in Singapore is you sweat. That's it. But you're a happy person, and mashallah, you keep on going. So this is why we say, work on that temper of yours. Work on it. Work hard on it. And be happy with yourself and thank Allah that you have controlled it. You know, when you, I think from amongst us, there are people who have a temper, bad temper. Sometimes you can see it in the eye. When I see someone looking at me like this, you know, one eye half closed, the other eye opened, and they're looking at you with a bit of a frown or the eyebrows, and you think, oh, I better not play games. And I look at them and say, Assalamu alaikum. Sometimes they look at you again, yes. And then they might break out into a smile, say, ooh, alhamdulillah, at least this person's okay, you know. But to be honest, sometimes we have temper in our blood. To sort it out, you need to work hard. Don't just say, well, I'm short fuse, so watch out, guys. Be careful, I get angry very quickly. Don't change that. You can change it. You can. Work on it. Cool your temper, especially in your family. Because most of us are cowards. You know what's a coward? At work, we act like little goats, and we come back home and we're a lion. What happened? As you entered the door, you transformed into a big lion. But when you go out, you're a little goat. May Allah safeguard us. Really, it happens. Why do you want to vent your anger on those whom you are supposed to be loving the most? Just because they are in a soft, vulnerable position? If that's the case, what type of a man are you? What type of a woman are you? May Allah safeguard us. Jazakumullah khair. Wa sallallahu ala Muhammad.